in their game against New Jersey the other night, especially the first period, they were awful. They were so slow, it was incredible.
Now here comes Nelson with a backhander. Elliott got just enough as it trickles wide of that near post.
It was a good play by Killorn there because Elliott was off the one side of the net.
Center right to Hagel. Spins away from Barzell. Brandon Hagel chips that one in. Elias Sorokin. Both the Islanders netminders, by the way, have good numbers to start. There's a rebound. Point scores. Brandon Point on the doorstep. And all of a sudden, Pointer's hot.
In such a big situation last night in Florida, the tire and then the winner in overtime. And you get to the right area. You get turnovers in behind the net. That's always important. And then your movement in front of the net. It's Point. He's observing. He gets his stick free. And just for a second, he gets away from Beauvillier. Beauvillier had him, and then he didn't. They both skate like crazy and have the puck a lot. And we'll see what their numbers are like from last year in the comparison in a few moments.
Puck comes free. The high slot. They score. Matt Martin. Rister buries it and ties the game.
Your own zone. The Lightning want to make a play into the middle to Myers. That was Corey Perry. He's on his backhand and he's under pressure off the wall. He's trying to give it to Myers. Now every team in the league does this.
Hedman pulls that puck out. Now with some pace, here comes Point. Straight up the ice. Point and shoots. Hits the puck. Behind Sorokin. They score!
Brandon Hagel really needed this one. On the rush, break Point, driving the defense back. And a weird shot. Sorokin just lost it. I don't know if it got deflected yet. Must have. It's bobbling. So it changed trajectory. He never saw it. It hits the crossbar and goes down. That's the key. And he has no idea where it is. But Brandon Hagel does. And Hagel just going to the net, gets inside position.
Here's Stamkos, bangs it back to the line. Final minute of the first period. Kucherov looks, moves into the slot, saved by Sorokin. They went 2-for-7 last night in the win against the Florida Panthers. Stamkos on the draw against the Zekas, and it comes free for Alex Killorn. Point picks it up. Looks back to the line for Stamkos. Here's Kucherov. Slap pass. Perry trying to tip. Sorokin down and it's cleared by the Islanders. And the 5-on-3 is over. Perry back there against Perry. Both guys collide and go down. And behind the New York net. There's Maroon. Belmar to Perry. He scores! Corey Perry bangs one home and it's 3-1 Lightning.
A big key on this is the forecheck by Corey Perry. He goes down and stays down for a second. That makes it an outnumbered attack at the net. Watch Pellick here. He's going to get hit right here. He tries to spin it. He goes in shoulder first. He didn't get hit by the numbers, but he never gets back inside. And because of that, the fourth line, that's where they live. They live on the boards. They live in the offensive zone. And then they get the puck into the paint. They usually score their goals from about 4 feet or less from the net. And that's one of them right there. Corey Perry's made a living of that.
Stamkos pulled it across to Killorn, and he just couldn't get it cleanly. Instead, the Islanders take off down the ice. Here's a pass. Backhander in there on Elliott, and it squeaks through and in, but the whistle had gone. That got into the net, and they're going to say the whistle went.
The 3-on-2 situation, it's actually a backhand shot by Beauvillier, who gets just inside Steven Stamkos, and where is it? That's the thing. Elliott thinks he has it, and even from up here, we thought it was Nelson putting it in. Perhaps it was over the line already. We'll get a better look here. Yeah, there we go. That's the reason. There you heard the whistle. From up here, I thought this one's not going to count because I thought Nelson had scored, even though we couldn't see the puck.
Hedman across. Quick shot by Kucherov, and it's tipped, and it trickles right down to the left pad. Final 10 seconds. Sochnikov winds it up. For a trip up the ice, and he is checked by Koepke.
I love that that kid likes to hit.
Here's Paul. He's got to shoot it. He does. He scores!
Brandon Powell with the buzzer beater. With zeros on the clock right after the hit by Koepke, it appears as though Nick Paul's got the fourth goal of the night.
And you think, well, I'm playing against the kid, but the kid turns the puck over. And then Nick Paul knows the time is wasting, so he doesn't waste any time. He doesn't try to drag it to the net or go behind. He's got to shoot the puck. And this one is a screenshot. Sorokin's off his angle just a tad. I think he got a little piece of it. Did he get a little piece? Nope, it just beat him right inside that post. Speaking of that line, here they go to start the period.
Islanders out hit the Tampa Bay Lightning 23-12 in that second period. But it was that big hit that you highlighted by Cole Koepke that gets it after that one in the corner. Point score, the opening goal of the game, and he's got the puck. Here's Paul, backhand and waits, swings it back out in front, and it comes right to Nelson. Coron with a chance to get to it. Islanders get there first. Barzal up top. Quick shot. Saved by Elliott on that quick release on the opposite side.
Nelson's moving in from the point. Here's Barzal. Under pressure, he throws that diagonal pass and knew Nelson was already moving down from the top. So the Lightning box defending means that the forwards have been pulled out.
And Barzal out there now with Martin and Cizikas. You're probably going to see a lot of 13 as much as he can handle here tonight. Knocked down to the point. Pullock. Hands on. Pullock shoots. Scores! Ryan Pullock waited and then pulled the trigger and makes it a one-goal game. 4-3.
As we've remarked, the change in how they want to play. And Pullock stays inside the zone. What a terrific read about seeing how the clearing pass is going to go up the middle. Steps into the middle, knocks it down, and now he's in immediate scoring position.
Team's back at even strength, and here we go. Out of the back to the way. Barzal drops this off. In front, tip, and a kick saved by Elliott. A beauty, his best of the night. Back to the way, come the Lightning. Here comes Paul, in, shoots, blocked, rebound.
Game and both teams really going at it. The Lightning on the attack, putting pressure on at every turn, getting the puck to the net. That's always the key. Alex Killorn comes in late, and boy, did he need this for his confidence. It has been a long time since Alex Killorn has been able to score a goal, and did he do that with some extra vigor right under the bar, almost put it through the back of the net.
Boyd trying to race away, and he does. Dishes off to Kucherov. Kucherov to Hedman. Slap shot and a save by Sorokin as Hedman just walked into that.
Victor Hedman, when he came out for his last shift, he's able to walk in into this shot from the bench.
Nelson has lost his ticket. Here comes Kucherov. Kucherov cuts wide, empty net, hits the post.
No!
Unbelievable. He could not have hit that more square on.
Let's go back to Kucherov. Not many guys make that move in the neutral zone to give yourself some extra time and room. Right here, that cutback. Both guys have been rushing it in the neutral zone.
A big faceoff, and he wins it again. Sergachev off the board, down the ice. Hagel, empty net. He hits the other post, but it doesn't matter.
Are you
Two empty nets.